Amanda Sellers. If it's happening in the area, it's on Carolina and Company Live.
It is a Thursday. Welcome to Carolina and Company Live. Man, this week has absolutely flown by because tomorrow, I mean, it's the weekend.
You got that right. We got a great show lined up today, some fun stuff. Everything you want to know about what's going on in the area, you can see it right here on this show.
That's right. There's our lineup right there for you. Of course, our Hollywood Minute, rolling into our video of the day, and then our celebrity birthdays.
Now, today's lineup, we're going to be talking about a lot of different things today. Now, first off, we're going to talk about, you know, people that have fire alarms in their home. They can hear them. But how about if you're deaf? We're going to tell you about a device that's going to wake you up because you can't hear that fire alarm.
And save lives.
Yeah,
really, right. Really.
Plus,
awesome.
We're going to talk about a high school rodeo that's coming up.
That's right. Kindkeeper Animal Rescue is here with us. And we're also talking about a big back-to-school bash event up at Lulu's. All of that and more coming up in just a second.
Talk about girl power. Maren Morris leads the nominees for this year's Country Music Association Awards. The Texas native receives 6 nominations, including Album, Singer, and Song of the Year for Girl, plus Female Vocalist of the Year. The CMA Awards are live from Nashville on November 13th. Appropriately, this year's theme is celebrating legendary women in country music.
Bribery, corruption, money laundering, millions and millions and millions of dollars. Somebody has to sound the alarm.
Crooked lawyers Antonio Banderas and Gary Oldman go up against Meryl Streep in the first trailer for The Laundromat, Steven Soderbergh's star-studded take on the global money laundering scheme uncovered in the Panama Papers. The comedy debuts on Netflix November 29th.
I don't know what happens. I'm telling you.
Matthew McConaughey is going to the head of the class, literally. The communication school at the University of Texas has made the Oscar winner a professor of practice to the Department of Radio, Television, and Film. The UT grad has been a visiting instructor there since 2015, teaching a film production class he developed. All right, all right, all right. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
All right, so listen to this. A woman in North Carolina got a phone call from a man trying to scam her out of personal information. He claimed she was going to be arrested if she did not provide him with her social security number and bank account information. But this just wasn't any kind of woman. And Stevens, she is the captain of the Apex Police Department. So Stevens used her experience to show how to deal with phone scammers. And guess what? When the man told Stevens she was facing charges and police were on the way, guess what she did?
She gave him the address for the police department. Stevens had someone record the conversation and then posted the video to the police department's Facebook page. Needless to say, the scammer didn't get anything from her. Stevens wants to remind others, don't ever give out your information and don't verify information when people call you up on the phone. Yeah, don't do it. Good job.
That's pretty funny.
I like
well,
that.
You know, and the same thing, we find a lot of people who just don't know about that. A lot of people, especially a lot of older people, they get worried and they get scared. So make sure that you never give out your personal information.
Never. All right, today's Thursday, August 29th, and this is More Herbs and Less Salt Day.
What?
More herbs.
You found that on the internet?
Yeah, of course.
That's great. It's also back to school again day. Here we are.
All right, let's check it out. Birthday today, 1993. There he is, Liam Payne. He's 26, a British boy band member of One Direction. 2012, the top new artist of the year. Received 18 Choice Awards. Now, as a kid, he took boxing lessons.
About that, 1966, Lea Michele, 33 years old. TV series Glee, also Scream Queens, started on Broadway in a Broadway musical, Spring Awakening, also appeared in Ragtime as a child.
All right, next up, Carla
Gugino.
48 years old. She was on the TV show Spin City, HBO series, Entourage and films, Night at the Museum, and American Gangster.
All right, so let's take it back. Today in history, 1956, Senator Strom Thurmond of South Carolina set a filibuster record in the U.S. when he spoke for, get this, 24 hours and 18 minutes.
He could do it. All right, let's talk about this one now. Let's go back to 1964. Roy Orbison's single, Oh Pretty Woman, was released, and the song was Orbison's second number one hit in the U.S. and his third in the UK. And he wrote it about his wife, Claudette, which he also wrote a song about. And now how he wrote the song, listen to this. It's cool. His wife was going shopping and he said, "Do you need any money?" And she said, "A pretty woman never needs money."
And he wrote a song?
And he wrote a number one hit.
That's it.
How about that? All right, let's look at this. From the know-it-all department, you learn something every day. And this one is, this one's going to hurt the dentist in Japan. Listen to this.
Okay.
Dentist. In Japan, crooked teeth are considered cute and attractive.
That does. That's not good for business there.
That's not good for business, is it? So if you live in China, you got crooked teeth, you're cute.
So
that's it from the know-it-all department today.
Oh, sometimes I don't have anything for him.
I don't either.
That's right. We'll be back.
Well, it's all about high pressure over the Tennessee River Valley at this hour, continuing to build to the east, although this high will retrograde west at some point in time. So it's just going to continue to pulsate, if you will, building east, building west, and growing. That's ultimately keeping our skies rather clear. It's not lowering our temperatures. Did overnight, not happening this afternoon with ample sunshine. What it is doing is lowering those dew points, though, feeling much more comfortable out there. High-res Futurecast keeping very clear skies throughout the rest of the day. 9 o'clock still clear. We continue on into tomorrow morning, still very clear. So again, just not a lot of stuff happening on our radar over the next 24 to 48 hours. Now by this weekend, rain chances will return, although they come from the sea breeze. Increased clouds will also lower those temperatures into the low to mid 80s on our Saturday and our Sunday. Few scattered showers and storms on Saturday. I think the better chance will be on Sunday, especially for inland communities. Now, talking about Hurricane Dorian, still as of the 11 a.m. advisory, wind sustained of 80 miles per hour. A little bit of a dry air entrainment within the system. In fact, you can kind of see right here at the very end of the loop that cloud-free sky. So it's still battling that dry air. NOAA hurricane hunters are out sampling the storm right now. About an hour and a half ago, they found hurricane force winds. They just did another pass through the eye, barely finding hurricane force winds. We're also finding a double eye structure, which indicates that dry air entrainment that I did speak of. That's the mid-level low from what was Tropical Storm Erica moving towards the Gulf of Mexico. That'll pinwheel around Dorian. The question is, will this high to its north be weaker, or does this low pull away at speed where Dorian slows down and can find a weakness to ride up the Atlantic seaboard? Still, several models are showing that as a possibility, but the official forecast cone following the consensus of the models right now, at least into Florida. What that means is for those in the Carolinas and for Georgia, doesn't mean that you're out of essentially the clear just yet. We'll be keeping a very close eye on it, but you can see the Hurricane Center now forecasting a Category 4 storm upon landfall. So scattered showers and storms Saturday and Sunday. We'll be watching next week, Monday through Thursday. Regardless if this storm does hit Florida or not, we are expected to see some tropical moisture. Just depends on when it hits Florida, determines when we get the rain.
All right, kind keepers, a no-kill shelter's with us today, and we're going to talk about what's happening there, and she has a guest with her, Nancy.
Very sweet.
We do. This is satellite because of the ears. Part hound, part pit, we believe.
He was
just left off. What a sweetheart. He's just...
You said that, so he was found with a couple others. They kept the others and they kind of left him, and he's a little sad. He needs a sweet home.
Yeah, he needs a home really bad. Someone who's going to love him and hold him and kiss him and just be there for him, because he's kind of lonely without his siblings.
I'm sure in a couple months of being in a great home, he'll be a completely different dog. Talk about, you were at the big event, the Furricane party that happened up at the convention center. You guys adopted out a lot of pets.
We adopted out a lot of pets. Everybody, we got along so well. Everybody helped each other out.
What a great community event.
It was a great community event, and I hope it continues every year, because it was good for the whole community, getting these dogs and cats homes that they need.
Over 250 animals total. That's incredible.
Over 250 animals.
That's incredible.
All right, now what's your need right now?
What's going on?
Volunteers always. We always need volunteer. We have a lot of events coming up this fall. We have Sand Hills Bank on Saturday, and Sunday we have Harley Davidson dealership. We're having
Sand Hill Bank, which where?
In North Myrtle, 17.
And motorcycles in North Myrtle Beach too, right?
Exactly. Yep. And that's from 12 to 3 on Sunday, and Sand Hills 11 to 3 on Saturday. So right. We'd love to see you there and help us out.
Also looking, of course, still for those monetary donations or even monthly membership type donations. That sponsorship. There it is.
If we could get a monthly sponsorship from different type of
people, businesses,
people, dealerships, whatever, any type of companies out there that can help us on a monthly basis.
Lots of expenses and
thank you,
stuff.
Nancy.
Awesome.
Appreciate
all right, Satellite, it. You're going home. Very sweet.
We got more stuff coming up. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
All right, Lulu's Restaurant up in North Myrtle Beach, always doing something great for the community. Right now having a back-to-school bash. It's going to be Sunday, September the 1st. We need everybody, the whole community, to come out to support some great organizations.
That's Lawrence here from Lulu's, and Bridget's here from Back Help for Kids. I messed that one up. All right, let's talk about, Lauren, let's talk about what's happening here now. What are y'all doing?
We are throwing a giant back-to-school bash Sunday from 1 to 4. We are going to be partnering with Backpack Buddies to collect school supplies for local county schools, collecting everything from snacks to notebooks, writing utensils, pencils, pens, anything you might need to go to school. We're going to have face painters. We're going to have a giant inflatable slide on the beach. We're going to have balloon animal artists. We're going to have cotton candy for the kids. Just so much fun stuff for entire families to come enjoy.
That's
yeah, well,
awesome.
There it is, the back to school bash. You see this thing right there. Now, Bridget, this helps, you know, Backpack Buddies and Help for Kids. I mean, y'all need all the help you can get.
Absolutely, we do. We have gone back to school in Horry County, but we still have kids that are, you know, saying they don't have school supplies or backpacks or pencils or pens or paper, so we're hoping to get that and get them caught up.
And even with that, you know, sometimes teachers, they feel responsible for having to supply that, and we want to help our teachers out too with, you know, the need that there is.
Absolutely, because the teachers do go out and buy things and give them to the kids, so this is kind of a way for us to prevent that.
So they can drop it off at Lulu's. Tell them where you're located.
We are located in Barefoot Landing, towards the back of Barefoot Landing where the Finger Docks are.
Right.
We are right beside Greg Norman's. You can't miss us. We're a giant hot pink building. We've got a ropes course and an arcade and all kinds of fun stuff.
So you're looking for anybody. Anybody can just drop them by. How about if they want to make just a donation,
absolutely,
you know, some money?
We'll take it.
Anything.
Absolutely.
But
anything to help out.
But bring the family out, right, and enjoy the event.
Of course, yeah. We've got so many festivities. We throw events like this through our entire off season. So we are ready for people to come in and party up at Lulu's.
All right, now how long has Lulu's been around here?
We opened June 9th of last year.
Last year, you've been up in a year now, so you're doing good.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Lots of fun. I hear a lot of people that go up and have fun. I've not been up yet, but I'm coming soon, I promise. Bridget, question for you real quick. Is there a website or somewhere we can go to find needs specifically that you guys may have, whether it's not even school supplies, but just other needs?
Helpforkidssc.org.
Okay.
Helpforkidssc.org.
Fantastic.
Well, thank you, girls. Hope y'all a big success. If you're out there watching and you want to carry some supplies by to help them out, Lulu's, go by and carry it to them in big bags.
What time again?
1 to 4.
One to four. Be there. Yeah. Perfect right. Timing.
Thanks, girl.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Fantastic. That's it. You know what we should do?
What's that?
The ropes course.
Yeah, I'm working.
I should
on that.
Get you on the ropes course. We can make a lot of money. That's a great fundraiser.
That is. I'm working on that.
Got my thinker going. That's right. We'll be back.
All right, you like rodeos? Well, let me tell you, we got one coming up, a high school rodeo. It's going to be held right up there in Lumberton, North Carolina. We got bronc riding, we got lassoing, anything, horse racing, anything you want. They're going to be up there. And Jerry's with us to talk a little bit about it.
That's right. What fun this event is going to be, especially a bunch of high school kids doing this.
That is correct.
Which is always awesome to see kind of that younger generation getting involved.
That's
Jerry.
Tomorrow coming. That's right.
All right.
You'd be surprised at they think about kids and they think there's not much entertainment. You'd be surprised at what these kids are capable of doing and how good they actually are.
That's pretty cool.
How good they can ride the bulls and how good they can rope and run the barrels and the poles.
All right, now how many kids are we talking about, high school kids, taking part in this roughly?
We don't know exactly how many. Yeah. The rodeo part will have 10 in each event, and then we'll have what we call slack, which I mean the rodeo is not going to last but 2 hours.
Okay.
And we'll have more entries than we have time for, so after the rodeo is over, then the rest of them get to compete. Also, and halftime for the entertainment, I'm going to be doing a border collie demonstration working herding cows.
Wow.
And we'll have barbecue ribs on Friday night, and we'll have barbecue contest cookoff on Saturday.
Yeah,
right, now, this is taking place, tell them where, at the Southeastern
Agricultural Event Center. They're in Lumberton, right off of 95 and 74. It's the first time that we've had their event at our facility. The Border Belt Horsemen's Association is who is putting it on for them.
Very
so we
good.
Invited them to come up and and use our facility, and we're sponsoring it and entertaining everything.
It's a great facility up there, too.
It is.
This is an annual event, and it comes off every year.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Every year, this time of year, we have something, and this year we decided to have the South Carolina High School Rodeo.
That's awesome. Wow.
Expecting a good crowd.
So everybody can come. Bring the kids up. Bring anybody. It's pure entertainment the time you're out there.
That's right. The whole 2 hours, and we'll have all day Saturday. We'll have stuff going on, games and all for the kids during the day Saturday before the rodeo starts at 8.
All right.
Rodeo starts, date on it, 8 o'clock at
Friday and Saturday night.
Right. Okay.
13th and 14th.
September 13th and 14th.
Right. Two weeks away. Only a week away.
We'll have barbecue plates prior to the sale.
Now, if I want to enter the barbecue contest, can I still do that? Are you full?
The North Carolina Barbecue Association,
okay.
The Pork Association, they're still taking entries.
Great.
So we have 10 already lined up to do the contest. So,
what kind of prize money to get?
I think it's $500 for first place.
Oh, okay.
And $300 for second.
A lot of people do that and travel around and cook all the time.
And it's points
to
qualify for the finals. That's great.
That's good.
All right, we're looking for excitement up here. High school rodeo.
That's right. Have you ever been to a rodeo?
Yeah, I've been to one.
I've been to one.
Almost rode a bull one time. Almost.
Hold on a second. Hold on. Jerry, can we get him on a bull?
Yes, sir.
I can do it.
Sure can.
Yeah. If I was younger,
I'd stay or not. That's the next
question. Jerry, thanks so much for being with us.
Stand by for this, you guys.
All right, we got more coming up. Coming up right now, if you're hard of hearing, smoke alarms, well, we've got something for you for the hard of hearing coming up. We'll show you how it works.
That's right.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
All right, talking about smoke detectors, normally when they go off, you can hear them, but if you're hard of hearing, this could be a matter of life or death. We're going to find out about an incredible device that these guys have brought with us to help save lives.
Yeah, and I can understand this, too, because I wear hearing aids, and at night you take your hearing aids
out.
And if you're hard of hearing, you may have a problem hearing that smoke alarm.
That's right.
Now, all right, Josh is with us now, and you're from the South Carolina Fire Marshal Association, right?
Yeah, yes, well, State Fire Marshal's Office, actually.
All right. Now, first off, we're going to talk to Denise, too, because she has one of these, but first off, tell us exactly what this is.
Yes.
Definitely. So this device is a bed shaker. That's what it's commonly referred to as, but it's also called a deaf or hard of hearing smoke alarm. So the deaf, hard of hearing smoke alarm works with smoke alarms in your home. So we encourage everyone to have working smoke alarms in every sleeping area, outside of every sleeping area, and on every level of the home.
Sure.
So this remotely goes to this then?
This is a smoke alarm, regular
right.
residential
yes, just regular
smoke
ones.
Alarm. And so this smoke alarm actually goes up on your wall or ceiling, and this listens for the deaf, hard of hearing community when they're asleep at night.
All right, let's show me how this works.
Yeah, show it, and then we're going to talk to Denise.
This goes under the mattress, this little piece right here.
That's right.
This is how it works.
This sits bedside.
Yep.
It also is multifunction. It serves as an alarm clock for them as well.
Perfect.
But the device on top listens for working smoke alarms.
All right, let's show it. Then we're going to talk to Denise about, she has one of these, and show us how it works and all.
Okay.
So we're simulating the smoke alarms in your home. And so this device listens for an actual activation. So we're going to play 3 cycles of a regular smoke alarm and before the device will actually go off.
Let's try it again.
We'll try it one more time.
It always works this way when you're on just
beautiful,
like
beautiful, yeah. Beautiful live TV.
That's
did
the way you, it works when you're on live TV.
There you go.
There you go. Here we go. It works. I saw it a minute ago.
I know it does. Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, we're going to get it to work. First, let me talk to Denise first. You keep trying.
Sure.
Get it to work. All right, Denise, you have one of these.
I do.
All right, now tell me how it works for you.
For me, it gives us peace of mind knowing that if something happens, I'm not going to be stuck or a statistic or anything like that in a fire. But my favorite part is that it doubles as an alarm clock.
Because so it can wake you up too?
Definitely. My husband likes to duck into deer hunt, and now he doesn't have to wait. Wake me up.
Go ahead and try it, Josh. I want people to see how this thing works because this is an amazing thing because people that are deaf, they don't hear that smoke alarm.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And this thing here will really, I didn't know it, so I could set it in the morning to get up and set my alarm and it'll wake me up.
Definitely.
Because I don't have an alarm anyway, I just wake up.
You know,
this is, I can't believe we're not going to get it to work.
Yeah, right it's now. Okay. We'll get it to work. We'll keep talking about it. What is something like this? Is something that I can just buy, off the internet?
So normally these devices are about $200 a piece.
Okay.
We have the ability through the state of South Carolina to offer these devices for free for citizens of the state. If they visit firesafe.sc.gov, There's a website under the citizen services portion. They can access the application.
Okay.
The application, we make sure that folks are, of course, South Carolina residents, folks who are 6 years of age or older, and then we ask them to take it to a medical provider okay. who they can certify that they are deaf.
Yeah. Try it again. We've got 30 seconds.
Okay.
We want to see it working.
I need to fill that out where I can get one of
okay,
these.
Okay, maybe if we have to be quiet.
There's
all
10
right.
seconds, we're still trying. What's crazy? When it goes off, this thing
jumps all over
around.
The table. Yeah. Yeah.
Unbelievable. Yes. It scared me when it came on a minute ago when we were testing.
Oh, good. Give me one of these things. So I can scare them all the time.
Lifetone, they go to Lifetone Technology. There's videos. This is not the typical environment that we would set a bed shaker off under.
That's right.
Well, I need this where I can fill one of those out.
Yes, all right. Please.
Thank
you.
Thank you guys
for being
with us.
Thank you,
my dear.
And if you, you know, Cecil's been in the business a long time. If you trust his opinion, it really does work.
It does work.
We'll be back.
Still trying to get it to work. I can't believe it. The first time we tried it, it scared me to death. It started shaking so
maybe
much.
You scared it as well. What do you think about that?
It might have. You need to check on this, though. If you're deaf, hear it?
Oh,
There it is. Look at it. It was doing it. There, look at it. Can you believe that?
Guess what?
Thanks,
it
everybody,
works.
For watching.
Have a great